Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
It's the Leduc Curling Club. It's the Curling Stadium Alberta Curling Series presented by Hardline Curling. And we are off. Draw one. Sae Yamamoto versus Lisa Parent. Lisa Parent out of Calgary, Alberta. Team Yamamoto out of Sapporo, Japan. Excited to get another weekend of high quality curling going. Japanese team Yamamoto will start with hammer. Wonder if the Japanese team is aware of Edmonton hockey star Kyler Yamamoto. With the Oilers kind of commanding the sports fandom in this region. It's a name they're familiar with, but I'm sure no relation. Just the familiarity. Two rocks down the ice. It looks like we're going to start things pretty open. Unless we get a center guard call from Lisa Parent here. Nope, we will not. Teams will feel out the ice. A rip and roll out, leaving the field of play open for Team Yamamoto. And they will throw a corner guard. Hey, why not? They have one rock left to use in the free guard zone. One rock after this, I should say. Lisa Parent will not be able to peel this off. Pretty optimal for Team Yamamoto. No center guards up front, no opponent stones and rings. Kind of a wide open house with three rocks gone. A free corner guard. Try to create 2 points in the first end. Now, interesting. They recognize that this one's coming deep, so they sweep it right in. The call was for a corner, but once they realized it was going to be in the rings and available to be hit, they decided, hey, why not make it good in case we get a flash here. Back to the predicted hits back and forth. One for one, nobody's missed a hit yet. Gives a good opportunity to learn these paths out to the wing. Gives the skip a little more confidence later in the game when they have to call another hit out here. That'll be a rollout. It'll give Team Yamamoto an opportunity to investigate yet another draw path. So no points advantages, no hammer advantages really, but for the team that is able to throw a few draws this first end, it's always nice going into the second end knowing that you've thrown a few draws, your sweepers, your front end have seen what at least a couple paths look like. Your opponent has thrown 8 hits in a row, really. Whereas you've thrown 5 or 6 hits and 2 or 3 draws, it's still a bit of an advantage. The team that kind of has thrown more draws might have that better idea of what things are doing, what the ice is doing. And they will make this corner guard. They'll leave this one high successfully. Pretty wide out there, but that's okay. Lisa has decided this end is not going to be favorable for her team, so she'll just hit any yellow rock in sight at this point. They could have tried coming top 8, top 12. Team Yamamoto still has quite a few rocks left to make some tap backs and freezes and maybe get 2 points out of it. So Team Lisa Parent will try their luck in the second end. Oh, they'll have to get this one out of play first. They'll roll it to the opposite side. Team Yamamoto will use this tight guard of Team Parents. I thought you might see a hit or a hit and roll, maybe a peel. Not as optimal a spot that is in the 4-foot line. So it might come in the way of an eventual draw, but with only 4 rocks left in the end, Team Yamamoto says, why not? Let's try to use this thing. Looks like they're sliding deep. Quite deep, back 12, so Team Parent out of Calgary is going to have an opportunity to put a 4-stone on the side of the 4-foot, make Yamamoto shoot against 1 or 2. A lot of room to curl on this one. Long way to go. Just got that one a little outside and heavy, I suppose. Didn't let the curlers work on, or the sweepers work on it. Sweepers are curlers too. I should clarify. Which team will make the draw first? That's what it comes down to in this first end. Could have been a blank. Team Yamamoto is the one who made the choice to continue to play with this rock in play. They could have peeled it off. So they will try to make something happen with it. Incorporate our first overhead view. 4 cameras to choose from on each sheet. Gives us a lovely view of the game. 2 overheads at each end. 2 high quality, high definition cameras above the center line on each end. Gives us a great view of the action. Team Yamamoto lying 2, though they're in the back of the rings. Can be very deal with a bull. Release apparent here. Might be lining up a hit and roll. Get rid of that yellow stone in the 8 foot, maybe roll on top of the other yellow stone in the back 12. See how responsive my cameras are here. See if I can't give everybody a little bit of a closer view of the action. Sweepers on it right away. Waiting for this one to move. Gets the top one, makes a little roll. That's going to be a made shot. Did leave the face of her own open just a little bit. Pretty tough, but I think Yamamoto can get to the nose of that. The way they're signaling their brooms, though, it looks like they might ignore it. Instead, if so, that's going to be a made shot for sure. Lisa Parent takes away a brewing troublesome end. Had the opportunity to meet Lisa a few weeks ago when we commentated a game together. I think it was in Leduc as well. She's been helping out with Curling Stadium Live, even producing a game or two on her own. So no stranger to the Curling Stadium Live technology. Not that we have favorites over here. Of course, I'm an unbiased commentator. Of course, very professional. Love our Japanese fans that have been tuning in every weekend, filling the chat with super cheerful, positive, fun-loving comments. It's been excellent digitally meeting these Japanese fans. Well, that's right about where Skip Sae Yamamoto. Sae Yamamoto. That's right where Skip Sae Yamamoto tapped the broom. So I think they're happy with that first rock fourth rock thrower, Mayu Ueno. Hey, your guess is as good as mine, but. Real nice shot there, especially her first shot in the first end. A draw weight shot, putting it right on the money. And now all of a sudden, Lisa's got to be careful not to leave a double here. But there could be a shot for three. You'd think that the back red would jam on the back yellow, but... Conversely, an opportunity to lie two here for Team Parent out of Calgary, Alberta. That would feel nice, making... her opponent draw against two in the first end. Gotta be happy with that. Lisa Parent, her last rock in this first end. First draw, hard line. Curling Stadium, Alberta Curling Series. Sweepers off of it for now. Waiting for the signal. Trying to sweep hard for curl now. They'll have to go to get a piece of this yellow. And they do get a piece. Not quite enough to bump it out of the forefoot. I don't think they hurt themselves, really. No shot for three that I can see. It will leave an opportunity for fourth rock thrower. Let's try this again. Mayu Ueno. A little better that time. And it'll be a repeat. of the first shot. Geez, that's always nice when you get to throw the same rock twice in a row, especially in the first end. So, Team Yamamoto makes good on it. Score two in the first end, kind of out of nowhere. Lisa Parent will try to score a few back after the break.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.
Welcome back, second end here in Leduc, Curling Stadium, Alberta Curling Series. It is December 2nd. We are getting into the thick of the season. These teams are more than warmed up. A couple months of competitive play under their belts already. Be having some trouble with the scoreboard there. Not exactly sure what's going on. But whatever the case, I think they got it figured out now. Throwing the Yellow Rocks, Team Yamamoto out of Sapporo, Japan. Known to Canadians, really, outside of the beer commercials. On TSN, I'm not sure. Sapporo in the north of Japan. Not that I'm very well steeped in my Japanese lore. What I do know, though, is Japanese curling teams are characterized by really exuberant team spirit, lots of high fives, lots of thumbs ups, pretty constant communication. You can see fourth rock thrower and skip kind of chatting at the hog line between shots, just kind of confirming what they saw. Even though both shots were made perfectly, they're just exchanging information. As we know, curling is all about exchanging information with your teammates, learning from your opponent's shots as much as you can, timing rocks, sharing those times with teammates. David Nedewin, I think, said curling is 2.5 hours of intense learning, and the team that studies the most usually passes the test in the 8th or 10th end. I could not agree with that more. Just because you know a sheet at one time doesn't mean it's not going to change and then maybe even change again and again and again. So it's all about communication. Looks like that first rock slipped into the rings. Team Parent ignoring it, trying to throw a corner guard. But Team Parent's rock slipped into the rings. So speaking of changing ice conditions, I think we're getting some second end quickies here. Things usually speed up in the second end. Especially with a full slate of games out on the ice, the warm bodies kind of give a little bit of a warmer layer on the ice. I don't know. I'm not a scientist, but I do know the second end is often quick. Talking about myself quite a bit, I haven't even introduced myself. Apologies there, audience. My name is Rory McCusker. I work for Curling Stadium Live. Absolutely having a blast bringing you this curling action from Leduc. Hey, camera set up in a curling rink and some of the world's best curlers. Definitely some of the best curlers in Alberta. That's a recipe for some great Friday night entertainment. So we'll be bringing you coverage from this event and many others all season long and all weekend long this weekend. Some other games to keep or tournaments to keep an eye on. Mixed doubles in Dumfries, Scotland. Those games are available on Recast Media. And of course, for free on YouTube, linked through curlingzone.com. This Hardline Curling Stadium Alberta Curling Series. So you have quite a bit of options as a curling fan what to watch this weekend. It is a great time to be a curling fan. So much free content. So many new teams to follow. You can watch teams kind of reach superstardom as they battle it out on this cash spiel circuit, which has always been a thing. My competitive curling parents told me all about the glory days of the old cash spiel circuit, especially on the men's side. Very developed, very established, you know, way of being at your best for playdown season, which I think is still the main goal for most of these teams, is to win their provincial or national championship playdowns. This cash peel circuit, I mean, of course, there's World Curling Tour points, very valuable to achieve, and of course, the money to fund your curling journey. The main prize at the end of the tunnel, end of the rainbow, whatever euphemism you want to use, is representing your province, your territory, therefore country, and, you know, wearing that jacket on the world stage. But very intense battles happening throughout the year on this cash spiel circuit amongst teams that you'll see in that playdown season. So long story short here, you don't have to wait till the end of the year to get high quality curling action when you have free curling available on YouTube, Curling Stadium Live. Okay, finally making something happen with those top stones. Ignored them for as long as they could, Team Parent did, but those overlap stones on the center line top of the 12 foot, you're not going to be able to tolerate those for very long. So gets them out of the way. Fortunately, rolls the shooter right off. They're hoping to keep the shooter around. This opens the door for Team Yamamoto to peel the red guard, leaving only Yamamoto stones in the rings. The bonus is they're frozen to each other. A little bit of camera lag there. Sorry, folks. It looks like one camera's ahead of the other. Should snap back fairly soon. In the meantime, let's see if we can't follow this slide. We've got second rock thrower. Is this third stones? I'm not too sure. I was too busy telling stories about how awesome watching free curling is. Regardless, it'll be a guard. Second end in an 8-end game. You want to score this end. So Team Parent could probably try to rip those yellow rocks in the back of the house and maybe go for a blank, but recognizing their best chance at scoring two is to throw a guard and make something happen there. It's always the chance that Yamamoto sticks a peel or they tempt them to go in themselves. That rock of Team Parents just didn't quite curl as much as they wanted to. Oh, no. She has changed her mind, which you're allowed to do, of course. Yeah, we are dealing with some camera lag there. Got it live now. It will be another peel. Makes that guard go away. Team Yamamoto pretty happy about their frozen stones in the back of the house. Let's see if I can get you an overhead. Yeah, so those two yellow stones on the side of the 12 foot, are they going to be great steel stones? Probably not, but removing them both in one go is going to be pretty difficult. So Team Yamamoto thinks they have a force opportunity with those two stones. They're pretty happy just peeling off the parent guards. Skip Sae Yamamoto knows that as long as she keeps the front of the rings open, she will have some kind of hit on hers. Make the troubles go away. There we go. Third rock stones now. They are going for this double. Gets one, gets two. Will they roll this one all the way out? Just didn't quite have the weight. Ah, very close. Almost makes it work. Team Yamamoto will try to avoid a double. If Team Parent can make a double, they will have a blank opportunity. Not as good as scoring two, but definitely preferable to scoring one, especially down 2 points. Sweepers have not touched this one. Hoping for it to slow down before it gets too close to the back one. Don't want to leave an easy double for Team Parent. And with a little tap, that's what they're going to leave. About a 1 foot double. Tough to miss this one. So Lisa's patience will pay off. They will get a double opportunity. And it will be thrown by her third, Sophie Brissett. Kept it clean the whole way down. Very nicely thrown rock. Oh, and perfect weight. Will it stick around? Well, it's rolling now. Ooh, did that cling? May have stuck around. No. Yamamoto is drawing, so they are pretty confident it's out of the rings. Skip Sae Yamamoto throwing the third stones. Skip throwing something other than fourth stones is steadily gained popularity. When I was growing up, born in 1992, I was there was only one team doing it. It was the best team in the world, Randy Ferbey. I think that gave people an idea. Hey, there might be something to this. Letting the guy who knows the weight and is throwing the rock the best right now throw last, and letting the guy that knows the game the best, knows where to put the broom, skip. I mean, there's two separate skill sets there in playing skip. Being an elite rock thrower and being a knowledgeable, experienced skip are sometimes two different things. So these international teams have definitely embraced that. You definitely see more lineup kind of changes in that way with a skip throwing some rock other than 7 and 8. More and more Canadian teams as well and American teams doing it, but still, you know, a pretty tried and true skip throwing the last rock. You'd see it on, I'd say, 90% of teams or more. Internationally, might be more like 75% of teams. Good weight call coming from second Caitlin Zeller. Just letting her third know where the weight's at. Allows him to call the rock more accurately. It's good skill calling weight, especially on hits. Rounding out the front end, Megan Johnson at lead. Team Yamamoto, front end. First rock thrower, Mizuki Hara. Second rock thrower, Suzuni Yasui. As you can tell, not very practiced. Not very practiced at saying Japanese names, but that's okay. I think we all know I'm doing my best. Commentators are always apologizing up and down for getting pronunciations wrong. Well, what can you do? Standard hit and roll. Team Parent pretty happy with a blank. At this point, we got him this one in. Pretty nice. Standard hit and roll out. And that will be a blank end. Kind of caught me off guard. I actually didn't realize that was the last rock. Blank end leaves the hammer with Team Parent of Calgary, Alberta. They'll try to come back down 2 points in the third end.
Sometimes curling just isn't as fun as it can be on the Nintendo Switch. With up to 4 players per console, you can enjoy curling with your friends and family anywhere, anytime. Let's play curling. Available now only on Nintendo Switch.
It is the third end. Some misses from both teams in the second end led to a blank. First, it looked like Team Yamamoto was going to have some kind of force brewing, and then Team Parent kind of fought control back. Ended up with empty free guard zone, empty rings, and that's how we finished. Lead rock thrower Megan Johnson delivering her stone. Weight's been a bit of an issue so far. And this one is sailing a little deep again. Yeah. So third end, third attempted guard that's come into the rings. So I believe Megan's going to have to clean that up if her team's going to have any chance of creating some offense early on. So just like that, it'll be two stones in the rings for Team Yamamoto. Kind of decision time for Lisa. Yeah, I think I agree with her. Even though looks a little squirrely in the house, you gotta keep at it. Try to get one corner guard up there. The opponent will not be able to peel it, so. Gotta try another one. Here's Megan's chance to get that weight down and keep it there. Oh, really unfortunate early pick. That one looked better for sure. Yeah, those ones you feel bad for. Yeah, they'll investigate that rock. That was not a small pick. That one really dug in, changed direction right away, right out of her hand, in fact. So, you know, it sucks. Never hoping for that, even the opponent. Never hoping for a pick. Team Yamamoto gets to do some extra work on solidifying their force setup. Coming this deep into the top 12 doesn't look like they're really trying to steal. They'd be throwing a center guard if they were, I would think. Trying to get this one in the rings, just create some extra work for Team Parent. A line was more important aspect of that call, and they'll achieve their goals there. A real good sweep gets that a bite of the top 12. Great scrub there from Miu Ueno and Mizuki Hara. Lead and fourth rock thrower sweeping for the second. Team Parent, second rock thrower, Caitlin Zeller. Getting in the hack now. It's like a bit of weight coming down the ice. Looking for a double here. Big sweep. She'll get one. She'll get two. Well swept, well thrown. Nice shot there. Caitlin. That's going to clean up a lot of the trouble in front. Gets two shots rolling for the price of one. It's going to be Team Yamamoto coming around that tight center guard. Very run backable. That's a huge shot by Caitlin. Really turned the end around. Went from having absolutely nothing going for them and actually looking at a steal prospect to now there's an opportunity, even if Team Yamamoto buries this rock. Team Parent's going to have an opportunity to run it back. Looks like it's coming up light, though. Big sweep is not going to be enough to carry this one. Little overlap on the center line there. Kind of helps Team Yamamoto. That rock is no longer available for promotion or run back. Straight backwards, anyways. Team Parent's going to have to try and manufacture an ugly deuce. I call it ugly because you have overlapped center guards, which is advantageous for the team trying to steal or force. The team without hammer likes overlapped center guards. It means if something goes wrong in the forefoot, there's not going to be an easy fix for Team Parent. They're committing to a scenario where they're not guaranteed to have control of the scoring area. And they could be looking at a situation on Lisa's last one where they don't have a shot. That's the risk of playing around center guards. And that's why I call it an ugly deuce. But can be done. Kind of tricked by the curl of that stone. It really sort of fell out on them. Kind of looked like it was moving backwards by the end. A tough break for Sophie Brissett there. Or for Zeller's second rock. A little slow on the camera there. Sorry, folks. Yeah, a lot to manage back here. This one's curling in really nice. Got the line perfect. Can they manage the weight? Slides a little deep, but that's a made shot. This the line on this ice, this sheet eight at Leduc, it seems to be pretty tough to manage. Not getting a ton of movement, so they have to play it pretty close to the center line. Always a little nervous doing that. Here is Sophie Brissett's first stone. Pretty big shot. If they don't get shot rock here, Team Yamamoto will be guarding for the rest of the end. And it does look like they are over curling. Kind of gave up on this one. Weight seemed close. Little tap rearranges the guards. Not sure. I suppose it's better than it was before. They still got a bit of a result out of that. Like I said, just trying to figure out that draw path. Seems a little tricky. Oh. Dealing with a bit of camera lag there. That's why you guys saw that movement. That's okay. Team Yamamoto smelling blood in the water. They know they have a good setup up front. Not really much improvement to make there. They're just going to take away this path to the button. With a made shot here, they're going to really take control of this end. This rock is curling pretty significantly. Lost some weight. Weight definitely came down on that one. They get a little tick off. Still going to be very helpful for their cause of clogging up the forefoot, protecting their stone that is shot rock. As we look at that red rock that got tapped into the top of the 12 foot, I don't think they can see enough to send it back straight on. So Lisa's going to be forced to send the wrong color into the house. No big deal. Just means if they stuff this run back, meaning if they stick the guard right on the stone that they're the target stone in the rings, it's still going to mean Team Yamamoto with control of the forefoot. So have to make this one a little more perfect than they would the other way. Sophie Brissett lines it up. Pretty big shot here. Big extension. This one's got some rotation and some weight on it. Sweepers are on it. Looks pretty close. Overcurled. Oh, gets the tick off. And a little lucky there. That's okay. That was always part of the game plan, I'm sure. Sophie is going to catch the target stone. She is going to send that rock back, and they are going to get the Yamamoto stone off the forefoot. Ends up working out really nice, especially for a rock that overcurled by about 8 inches. Still, though, advantage, Team Yamamoto. Tight center guard. A parent stone in the 12-foot that's going to be pretty tough to tap back, even if they wanted to. And with the initiative on the hand of fourth rock thrower Miyu Yino. Scratch that. Miyu Yino. That's three vowels in a four-letter word. I don't know how to say that. I'm sorry. Miyu has been throwing really accurately tonight, despite my butchering of her name. Having some trouble getting curl out of the end of this stone. That's been a theme all end. Teams have been playing really tight to the center guard, and as a result, there's been lots of wrecks. They do end up getting it to the center line. Perhaps it was a bit heavy, and the sweepers had to wait on it. That's a made shot, I would say. It did come deep, but the goals are accomplished. Yamamoto is line two. They're forcing Team Parent down the middle. Even if Lisa makes this shot, Team Yamamoto knows what this spot is doing. They've thrown many intern draws right around here. So there, and especially Miyu has just thrown a recent rock there. She knows all she has to do is take about 4 feet off her weight. And it's going to be perfect. So a tough deuce, an ugly deuce, you heard me say earlier in the end. Building up here. As strange of an end as this has been, and as bleak as it's looked at times, Lisa, with two good shots here, can score 2 points. And it's not overly difficult. She's just got to make one good draw to the forefoot, and then whatever else is demanded of her on her second. Starts with this draw right here. Sweepers are on this one right away. Okay, taking a look now. Waiting for the curl. This has got potential for sure. Looks a touch heavy, trying to get some extra curl out of it now. That's going to sit at the back of the forefoot. And Team Parent is lying one undercover. Of course, that came a little bit deep, but that'll do the trick. Lying one, very available for Team Yamamoto to come in, sit on the button, take that shot for two away. But at least you're making them throw it, and at least you are not throwing yourself against multiple Yamamoto counters. Big shot by Lisa there. Try to save the end. Giving up a single point is not the end of the world here. Third end of an 8-point game. You give up a single, you come back in the fourth and get your two. It's a 1-point game at that point with four ends to play. In trouble, but not in extreme danger yet. Miu Ueno. Fourth rock thrower for Team Yamamoto. Oh, bit of a camera skip there. Looks like they were waiting for the curl and it just never quite came. May have gotten a little outside. Maybe that extra weight stopped it from grabbing in the right spot. Whatever the case, it's going to come deep. And Lisa's going to have a chance to repeat her previous shot for 2 points. Wow, 2 points out of this end. Did not see that coming. Started with Sophie Brissett's made run back. She kind of ticked off the top red and was able to make the two rocks move that Team Parent was trying to move. Got a bit lucky there, but they'll take it. And some heavy draws by fourth rock thrower Miu Ueno has left this door open for Lisa Parent. Make a draw for two and tie this game up in the third end. What a swing. Gives me a chance to use my last rock button. Last rock, third end. Sweeper's never off it. Lisa knows she was a bit heavy on her first one. Couldn't throw any more. I fear she's thrown a little too light this time. Yep, sweeper's off it as it hits that top red. You can see Lisa's disappointed with herself. She knows she just had to repeat that previous shot. May have overthought it a little bit. 1 point for Team Parent out of Calgary, Alberta. Not over yet. Though Team Yamamoto out of Sapporo, Japan will have the hammer and a point in the fourth end.
The Roaring Game. We all love it, but sometimes curling just isn't as fun as it can be on the Nintendo Switch. Don't get stuck in your curling club this year. Learn the game inside and out. Play for your favorite country and take the curling world by storm. With up to 4 players per console, you can enjoy curling with your friends and family anywhere, anytime. Let's play curling. Available now only on Nintendo Switch.
Welcome back, fourth end. Some missed shots to start this game. It's the first draw of the Curling Stadium Alberta Curling Series, brought to you by Hardline Curling. Curling Stadium Live here with the live images and sounds. Just want to thank our ever so attentive audience. Thank you so much for the lineup correction. I've been going off of the standard lineup that they register under the World Curling Tour. Bit of a different lineup. We have Skip Sae Yamamoto throwing last rocks. I have been saying fourth rock thrower Miu Ueno, who is that their normal position, but she is not here at this tournament. So Sae is throwing fourth rocks this week. So looks like we have to identify a third or a second, which hopefully we can do soon for you. But Megan Johnson gets her weight back, gets that rock in the guard zone. Unfortunate pick on her second one last end, so we'll be watching this second stone carefully. Team Yamamoto going for a corner guard. Love it. Up a point with hammer. They're still on offense. think the signal was for a center guard. Probably a little deeper than the first one. Working hard to get this over. Looks like a repeat of the first rock, so unable to make the adjustment. Those are going to be not optimal center guards. They're going to be useful, although you can see by the angle there, there will be a very available double peel at a certain point. So unable to make that call yet. Sae Yamamoto will signal a draw behind their corner guard. Well-placed corner. I'm being told this is the regular first rock thrower, Mizuki Hara. That rock to a really nice depth, but they don't quite get the curl they were looking for. It's going to be available for a hit, basically wide open that shot. So gets the weight right, not quite the line. Good weight call from lead Megan Johnson there. Gets the hit, does roll out. Gotta think that's gonna tempt a peel from Skip. Sae Yamamoto, and yes, it will. Two points up with hammer. No real reason to take risks right now for Team Yamamoto. One and two, gets the third one flying as well. That's quite the cleanup job. Just kind of the way that the angles lined up. A little bit unlucky for Team Parent, but you know, that's why you want separation with your center guards and putting those two guards right next to each other is always going to tempt that kind of result. So Team Parent will start over, try to clog the middle. Try to force their opponent into dealing with some difficult stones down the middle. They might get a stuck peel or a nosed peel from Team Yamamoto, maybe a flash. Maybe Team Yamamoto rolls to a place where Team Parent can hide behind. Lots of rocks left, lots of room for mistakes, so no need to give up quite yet. And there's the stuck peel they were hoping for. I mean, that did roll over for a corner guard. Perhaps they were calling that. If they were, it's a heck of a shot. You know, curlers are not used to making pretty specific hits and rolls with rocks in the guard zone. You're used to ticking those off by catching just a little bit of the stone. You're used to peeling those by catching half of the stone. It's not very often you're trying to manage that inch and a half over nose. Pretty risky if you overcurl by an inch or two, you stick for a center guard. So if they were going for the hit and roll for a corner guard, it's an aggressive call and a well-made one. Sweepers are signaling this is up. Love the hand signals, ladies. Let's me know what's going on. And of course, all the viewers at home. She's got a bit of a focus issue with that camera. Let's see if we can't snap that thing back into gear. There we go. This will be a hit and roll. Team Yamamoto now has two corner guards to work with, so they will be looking for a score of two this end. Lisa Parent will have somewhere to hide behind at the end of this end. So if someone's scoring this end, which it looks likely like someone will, may as well be Team Yamamoto, and it may as well be two instead of one. So Lisa Parent also recognizing, hey, there's no cleaning up this mess. Not much else to do, especially in the fourth end, down a point. Then to throw another center guard, see if they can't get something cooking down the middle. Take away those corner guards by occupying the center line, forcing Team Yamamoto at the end of this end to forego their corner guards and instead chase down the middle. That's the goal for Team Parent right now. Looking for some curl. This rock looks all right. Sweeper's kind of standing at the side of it. Not too far off where Lisa tapped her broom. It's a nice, well-made shot. A pretty good game so far for Sophie Brissett. Yep, Sae Yamamoto not loving that center guard. I think she'll make a play to deal with it right now. Team communicating right now. Making sure they're getting the turn, going down a path that they know. Just going for the straight peel. Makes it nice. However, with only two rocks to come, Team Yamamoto may have just changed gears. Instead, looking for a blank. Lisa knows there's only two more opposing rocks to face, so if she can bury one here, it would force her opponent to outcount her stone in order to count two. And now, if she was able to maintain shot rock after this skip-for-skip trade, Lisa would put her second stone somewhere else in the rings to lie two, and that would be a pretty effective force, as long as she didn't leave a double. I'm thinking that's what they'll be going for here. Nice straight release. See, that rock's coming directly at the broom. Sweepers are waiting for it to move. I think it's a bit heavy. And it is. It does look like that thing is cruising. Oh, kind of hitting the brakes at the end. Will it cling on to the back? No. Sails through the rings. It's a tough one. She threw that so nice right at the broom, just 7 or 8 feet too heavy. Line looked pretty good as well. So, open draw to lie a single point. It'll force Team Parent to make a nice one, try and get rid of the Yamamoto stone. Now, both of these guards are quite high. It's going to be tough to get a rock totally buried with no hack weight hit available. This hasn't been super swingy ice, not a ton of curl so far. So that will favor the team drawing, as the slower stone will catch more curl. The faster stone going hack weight might stay a little straighter for longer. Sweepers don't want to go. No, is what I'm, the hand signal I'm seeing. Looks like they've caught a pretty quick path here in the fourth end. Ooh, dying now. We'll try to get a bit of curl. They will try, but as we can see from that straight on shot, not going to do it. Wide open, available for a hit. Lisa will try to roll behind one of these corner guards, make it, make a blank attempt difficult for Team Yamamoto. Hopefully get her force here in the fourth end. Be a big swing here if she's able to get this thing buried. Could be the difference between a force and a blank, which in the fourth end, pretty big difference, significant impact on your chances of winning the game. Lisa Parent threw her first one pretty well, just heavy, trying to make the same thing happen, take a bit of weight off of it. Really trying to make this curl. They played a down weight, thinking it would curl a bit more, but that is going to blow right by. I think they just misread the ice there. Maybe Lisa got outside of the broom. Actually, yeah, now that I remember where the broom was, she did throw that on the opposite side of the center line. Nice positive release that's going to work out for her pretty well on more swingy, competitive arena style ice, but for this particular night, on this particular sheet in Leduc, that was too much positivity. So let that rock grab some curl. This will be a repeat throw. Yamamoto will have to just throw the same rock she just threw. Sweepers seem to think it's close. And with that rock starting to move off the center line, pretty good indication that it has slowed down, caught the curl, and it will be score two for Sae Yamamoto in the fourth end. Takes a controlling but not a guaranteed 3-point lead into the fifth end. Team Parent will bounce back. We'll try to bounce back when we come back.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next curling stadium.
Well, I ran every commercial in my library, and these teams are still taking a break. A little fourth end break. First draw here in Leduc, Alberta. Team Yamamoto got the snack platter out and everything. Yeah, a good time for me to take a little sip of water. Maybe yourself as well. Run and grab a drink. Hey, it's Friday night. And you got free curling on your smart TV or laptop or phone or however you're watching tonight. Loving to see these chat entries in the comments. Yes, we do read them. And we'd love to see them. So thank you all you fans who choose to participate with us. This is the way of the future, interactive media. Hey, Rick, Branford, super fan. Rick's always got time for curling. Lots of Japanese fans tuning in. Hey, Megan. Geez, sneaking in a good 5 minute long at this point. Halfway break. Nothing really Team Parent can do about it. Yamamoto is shooting first. May as well update you on some of the other games out there. Of course, if you want to watch any other game on the ice live, you know where to find it, curlingzone.com. Shouldn't say every other game on the ice, but 1, 2, 3, 4, looks like we got 5 going right now. 2 Edmonton teams, Krista Hilker and Kelly Stixma. Stixma is leading 4-1 in the fourth end. Nikki Kaufman and Trina Ball, both Edmonton teams as well. Tie game. Kaufman has the hammer in the fourth end, 1-1. 2 more Edmonton skips. Deb Santos and Elisa Crow. Crow's getting the what metaphor am I trying to say here? Crow is losing 8-0 in the fourth end. Crow does have hammer to try and take a stab back, but giving up a steal of 3 and then a steal of 4, not going to turn out very well. Edmonton's Michelle Hartwell taking on St. Albert's Adele Purcell. Lots of local women's teams. Purcell has the hammer in the fourth end, but she is losing 3-0. Emily Clark and Jesse Hunkin. Westlock, Alberta, and Edmonton, Alberta. Clark has the hammer in 4. She is down 2-1. Jessica Wytrachowski out of Calgary and Gracelyn Richards. Wytrachowski leads 5-0. Richards has hammer in the 4th. And Kayla Skirlik out of Calgary, Alberta. Marla Shearer, Lacombe, Alberta. Tie game. Skirlik has the hammer, 1-1 in the 3rd end. And of course, our game. 4-1 for Sae Yamamoto. Team Lisa Parent getting outplayed, I would say, at this point. Pretty fair to say. Lisa missing both her shots in the fourth end. Had a force or at least a blank kind of lined up, but came heavy on her draw and then a little outside on her hit. So 2 missed shots, going to put Yamamoto ahead 4-1. Of course, Sae Yamamoto making both her draws. First draw didn't quite curl enough, left it outside, but It was good enough for 2 points that end. We'll start with a deep Yamamoto stone in the back eight. Ooh, might make it two. Yeah, first rock thrower just couldn't make the adjustment. Actually throws the second one a little deeper than the first. As a coach, you never like seeing that. You always want to see the adjustment made. Megan Johnson making her best guard of the game. Halfway, corner guard, protecting the edge of the 8 foot. That's exactly where you want it. Lisa feeling the pressure, wants to throw two corners here. Really wants to give her the best, herself the best chance for 2 points, even if Team Yamamoto decides to play conservatively and peels guards. Sailing a little deep. Yeah, unfortunately, that one's just going to overcurl to the point of not being very useful. That depth might have been savable, but that amount of curl is just not going to do the trick. And Team Yamamoto is going to throw another one, attempting to go in the top of the rings, attempting to lie three at the end of this. So even if Team Parent was to use their corner guards, they would have a lot of work to do down the middle to clean up the Yamamoto stones. Pretty light. They're going to come up there. Well, this is draw one, folks. I mean, lots of times in these tournaments, the first few draws are not broadcast. The teams definitely have an adjustment period. They're learning the ice, understanding what their type of throw is going to do on the ice conditions that they find themselves in that particular weekend. Lots of these teams traveling quite a bit, playing, you know, half dozen, maybe even more tournaments in the competitive season as it leads up to playdown. So before Christmas, lots of these teams will be playing between three and, you know, six, seven, eight tournaments. Anyways, every ice condition is different. It takes a little bit of adjusting. Team that is going to catch on the quickest here and repeat good throw. Seen a lot of two good shots in a row. An open opportunity for a come around. Not a terribly missed shot by Team Parent, but enough to come deep and not get shot rock or second shot. Geez, another missed light. The second rock thrower for Team Yamamoto. Kind of an ugly game right now. A lot of misses. Neither team really dictating play. Lisa is gonna think to herself, this is just too much down the middle. It's an opportunity to make at least one or two go away. A run back double here would really swing the end in Team Parent's favor. They'll send one back. Will blow by everything. Rolls that one for another center. That did not help significantly. It did get that troublesome intern path open. But rolling for a double center guard, no, not part of the plan. But as you can see, it is at the point for Team Parent that they're going to have to put the onus on themselves. There are some hard shots that they're going to have to try and make. Down 3 points with the ends kind of melting away on them. There does come a time where the patience sort of runs out. It becomes do or die. So this fifth end, especially with these ugly looking center guards for Team Parent, they are going to try their best to make some big shots, try to turn this thing around. Another light draw from Team Yamamoto. So the door consistently opening for Team Parent. Let's see if they can do something with this. Might be time to give up on clearing the center and just try to score that ugly deuce that we were talking about. And I think that's what Lisa has settled on. Setting the broom in the 12 foot. Yeah, I think this is going to be an intern draw. Try and use what she has. Which is 3 center guards. All of them overlapped. None of them really available for run back. There's a yellow-red combination that she could play at some point, but she will ask. Third rock thrower. Sophie Brissett to come in around. Sweeper's working really hard on this one. Will they get it by? No, it's on the top one. Both teams unable to adjust. Coming to the center line, that's a lot of rocks in a row that have finished heavy. I'm starting to think that it's a little bit stiffer going away. So coming home, coming back towards the glass and the even ends. The rocks seem to be sailing quite a bit further, whereas going away, going towards the far end of the rink and the odd ends that we're seeing right now, rocks are seeming to grab quite a bit. Seems to be 6 feet or more difference. Both teams getting caught on this over and over again. Another light draw. Perhaps if the line had been better, they could have swept this one around. They may have gave up early just to let it wreck and stay along the center line, but look at this mess. Although, this is a big enough mess that Lisa can use this to her advantage, try and score 2 or even 3 down the middle this time. I don't think those yellow stones at the back are going anywhere, so if they're going to score 2 or 3, it's going to have to be with these 3 shots right here. Sophie's last and Lisa's 2. For Sae Yamamoto, it is A-okay if Team Parent gets 1 rock in that 4 foot. They can continue to seal off the path and force them to 1 pretty effectively that way. I see really only 1 tap back available right now. So does Lisa. So Lisa doesn't want to play her open red rock, knowing that once they make it, there will be a guard coming, and then their path to the 4 foot is totally cut off. So using Sophie's last rock here, she will make 1 more attempt at clearing out a path, clearing these yellow rocks out of the way to give herself options. Team Yamamoto can't guard everything, but they certainly can guard one path. And that's all Team Parent has available for them right now. Throwing some weight, they're looking for some curl here. And you can already see this is significantly outside. They push one out of the way, and they will smash one of the Yamamoto stones out of the way. So that sorta does the trick in a way. I mean, I think Yamamoto is gonna come right in now, but at least Team Parent has two paths to use. They have a tap back on the intern side, and there is an open draw right now on the outturn side. But with the initiative, Team Yamamoto will be taking that away. Third, just signaling, hey, it's okay if we end up a little bit light here, as long as we take away the path. That's the important thing. But you got to know, Skip Sae Yamamoto knows for a fact the best spot for this rock, halfway in the 4 foot, 3/4 tucked. And that's what she'll be shooting for here. With her first stone in the fifth end, up 4-1, trying to limit the possibility of a big end for Team Parent. Line looks really nice. Do not want to be deep here. You don't want to give Lisa Parent something to draw onto. And unfortunately, looks like that's what they did. A little bit of an oversweep off the bat. That may have been heavy the whole way anyway, but the sweepers definitely underestimated. Sweepers got that one wrong. They took it deep. Going to be a nice pocket for Lisa to draw onto. It's sounding a lot like the third end, where Lisa was able to create an ugly deuce for herself, used some missed rocks by Team Yamamoto. Some heavy draws, in fact, exactly like this end. Had a chance at two, could not make her second draw for the second point. Very similar setup. Let's see if Lisa can make it happen, two in a row. And these rocks. Boom, boom. Fist pump from either side. Good to give your Skip some extra confidence as she gets in the hack to throw this one. Can really flip the game around with the deuce here. Skip Lisa Parent with her first in this fifth end. Sweepers have been digging this really hard the whole way. Every inch they drag this really helps them. So, oh, this might even have a shot at getting right in there. Can they get that last little bit of curl? Great sweep end to end. I don't think they got shot rock, but that's a terrific effort. Sweepers Megan Johnson, Caitlin Zeller. They knew right from the get-go that one had to go. Unfortunate if Lisa throws that about 4 feet heavier, the sweepers can wait, let that rock catch some curl, and then go harder at the end, try and get some better line out of that. Maybe would have caught a bit of the 4 foot for shot rock, maybe. But they were right. The sweepers were absolutely correct. They had to go on that the whole way. Just doesn't quite get the curl to get shot rock as a result. Now, all of a sudden, with the inside edge of that rock showing, Sae Yamamoto has a chance to count four in the rings, forcing Lisa to throw her final stone against four. Ideally, you would think that Sae leaves her stone just right on the nose, take away that outturn path. leave no potential draw. Oh, looks like they're talking about throwing a guard, maybe. Not a crazy call. A guard would leave them lying two and would leave Lisa with some type of tap back. Looks like the team's still discussing it now. And their coach has signaled for a timeout. Coach did not like that indecision he saw. This is kind of, you know, you're really wrestling between two really good scenarios. Even if Sae did not shoot this stone, there is no shot for two. Lisa would have an angle tap, or maybe she would still try to go straight draw, sort of roll in. But the point is that there's only a shot for one at this point. Maybe some very difficult inside out run back on her redstone on the top of the 12 foot. But point is, Team Yamamoto is sitting very well right now. So I think that's where this idea of the guard comes from. Hey, we're looking pretty good as things are. Why don't we just take away her easiest shot, make Lisa play something against two, even if it's just for 1 point, we'll be 2 points up with Hammer going into the sixth end. And that's a reasonable idea. What I would say is it's not difficult to make that hit and stick or hit and roll in. I know that there's a little bit more risk. Sae could miss outside, could jam the redstone back. Us giving Lisa a shot for two, depending on how those yellows split off, perhaps even a shot for three. So by throwing the guard, you do eliminate the risk of helping your opponent, but that hit and stick, like, you're looking at game over. If you can make that, sing Lisa into a super tough shot. If Lisa misses that shot, you're counting four. That's what I would be tempted on that red in the rings. But as we just discussed, the line has been an issue. There's some stones have been falling out, some not curling and even kind of moving a little backwards against the grain. So there's definite risk to hitting that red stone. And I think that's what the coach may have been indicating. You did see the third change the broom. Sae had put the broom down for a hit. And the third kept signaling for a guard. Geez, I hope she didn't look up and see the coach's signal or anything like that. But we cannot assume that. This might be the right call. No risk involved in this one. Lie two, force your opponent into a very difficult shot. That's what they'll do. Sae Yamamoto with her last rock in the fifth end. Looking pretty good, trying to look a little better. Sweepers are sweeping for line. The weight looks excellent. This is looking like a made guard, but to make the angle tap, you have to take a wider line than that anyway. So I'm not sure that really took away the shot that they were trying to take away. I think it did make it significantly harder. We can see from that straight on camera, obviously be preferable for Elisa if she had access to that entire stone. But she needs to tap that at an angle. Anywho, so. It appears the guard did the trick. Lisa's already looking at this alternate shot. This is the shot for two. If she can run this stone back and make contact with both yellows, even if she moves them just a few inches, that's going to be enough to lie one and two. So shot for two still available for Lisa Parent. It's another reason I really liked the hit and roll or hit and stick call on the previous one. It totally eliminates any opportunity for two. inside out, medium weight, run back, going across the face of your stone. There's just so many difficult elements to this shot. It's going to be a really impressive one if Lisa's able to make this, even for one. Backs against the wall, Team Lisa Parent, Calgary, Alberta. Trying to get this game within 1 point. Her last rock in the fifth end. Already getting some curl. Looks pretty close. Trying to sweep for some extra movement. And it will not curl up. Geez, really straight spot. She threw that with really nice weight. They just weren't able to get the movement. So that will be a steal of two for Team Yamamoto. Takes a pretty controlling 6-1 lead into the sixth end. Team Parent will look for a big score to try and bounce back when we return.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
Welcome back, sixth end. Oh, have not updated the scoreboard, but I assure you it is 6-1 for Team Yamamoto. Team Parent with hammer still. Door was open. Lisa Parent almost so close to making her first stone. Sweepers went hard the whole way to drag it. They come up just a rock length short. Couldn't quite get shot rock. Left Yamamoto an open opportunity to either hit or guard. They chose to guard. Did the trick. Forced Lisa into a very difficult inside out, run back, hack weight thing. Very difficult shot, especially in the first game. Your first time on the sheet of the tournament. She threw it quite well, right at the broom, actually. Just didn't curl up enough for her. Tough break. They will try to score. I would say you're really going for three right here. Try and get the game within 2 points. That way you can realistically force your opponent to one in the seventh, score another three in the eighth to tie the game. Tall order, but I've seen it done. Jacques Gauthier just a few weeks ago gave up a 5-point lead in this many ends. I also watched Brendan Botcher and his old team at the Briar in Brandon 2018. Come back from a 5-point deficit and they won the game. No extra ends needed. They won it in eight. So it does happen, although extremely rare. It does happen. Blows that one through the rings, but with a 5-point lead, that's A-okay. You're better off, unless you're going to put it right where the skip called it, you're better off through the rings. Team Parent's going to throw another corner guard, maximize their use of the free guard zone. That'll do. Two corner guards, decent bit of separation, no really easy double peel available. That's a job well done. Sweeper signaling way up, way up. Making the no sign. That's adorable. May as well sweep this one all the way through. Yeah, you can see the delay between our two cameras there. It will go to the back 12. A bit of an advantage for parent, only in the sense that they can use that to freeze too later on. For now though, gotta make use of those corner guards. Which means curling a rock behind them both. You can see how little ice she's taking. It's just that's how little movement they're getting from inside to out. That's the same kind of path where she threw her attempted run back, where her hack waiter just got very little curl. So they're using that information, translating it into their next shot, which is all you can ask of your team. This one's moving in nicely. Sweeper's really working on it. Comes up just a little shy, but that's okay. That's a useful spot, promotable in the way. Three more or less nade shots by Team Parent so far this end. Finally able to string a few together. Every make seems to be followed by a miss, really for both teams so far, just Team Yamamoto missing a little less. And before it sounds like I'm being too mean to these teams, it is the first draw of the tournament. Bit of a warm-up draw for everyone. We'll be seeing some weight here. Peel number one complete. Not a super tall task being asked, but you still got to make them. Making the attack on this rock in the top 4 foot right now. There had to be a move made on this stone at some point. This feels a little early for me, but you gotta move it eventually, so we'll take this opportunity right now. Trying to get a little roll underneath their own corners. Looks like they'll settle with nose. And they do remove a stone at the back. Not sure if that's super advantageous or not. May open up a split or a tap possibility on their one at the top. I'm not sure, but shot rock will be wide open, available for Team Yamamoto to remove. Definitely getting more curl on this intern across the center line half. They will get the rock, they will roll to the open, and that's going to be a fine result. One rock in play for Team Yamamoto. Ensures someone is scoring this end. Doesn't ensure, it helps. Helps make someone score this end. Very, very tight ice being given to Sophie here. I think on this side of the center line, they are going to get more movement than you might expect. Sweeper's working on it. They can see that rock curling. now that it's cross center line, straightening out a bit, but just light weight was a bit of an issue on that one. It's a good line. Sweepers read it very well. Just couldn't quite get the oomph on that one. Yamamoto knows that she'll never clean up all those guards. So at this point in the end, may as well try to warp another one in there. You're already lying one in the rings. Try to get another one in the forefoot. As long as you get a piece buried, there's not going to be an opportunity to roll in. Just taking another look at that peel opportunity. Up 6-1, it's never a bad idea to hit red stones. Quite a decision here. Seems to be hum-hawing back and forth. Doesn't quite know which one to go with. It looks like they've settled on this peel. I don't know if I like this. It's this late in the end. There's only three rocks to come from Team Parent. I don't know what you're accomplishing by getting rid of these stones. There's still going to be a guard to draw around. Will go bang. It will go over top of their stone on the side of the 12 foot. They were afraid of that, of what might happen there. It's yet another reason not to play that shot. But they get away with it. Although they leave their shooter basically right where the other guards were, and the shot for Team Parent unchanged. I think you just gave Lisa another opportunity to put the first one in the 4 foot. Feel like you could have beat the opponent there, but what do I know? They're out on the ice and I'm in my living room in Regina, Saskatchewan, streaming curling. You should definitely trust in their instincts over mine. Great line, great weight. That's got to feel good for Team Parent. Finally made a shot right the way it was called. Nice sweeping sort of arc on that one, a heavy clean, and then went hard at the end to get that extra curl. That's a really good reward for a well-placed stone. Team Parent maybe wishing they found that magic a little earlier in the game before they are down 5 points. Going for a pick is what we would call this type of shot. Just trying to catch a piece of it, rip it out of the forefoot. Sweepers don't want to touch it. Let's see if it gets a little bit of curl at the end here. Looking close. Oh, they do kiss it. They move it just a little bit, but not enough to remove the stone. Ah, tough spot. So, Team Parent. This has the makings of three. If they're able to get another rock behind the guards into the 4 foot area and they bury that stone with the overlapped guards, Team Yamamoto is going to have no clear shot on how to remove either of these red stones. So huge opportunity for Team Parent here to bounce back into this game. All they have to do is bury about, you know, three quarters, ideally a full rock. And they're going to leave Sae Yamamoto with the same type of pick shot which now that Sae has moved that rock over an inch and a half, it's going to be that much tougher. Sweeper's on and off of it. Looks pretty good. Trying to get that late finish now. Real potential for this one. Just cruised a little further than they expected, but that's okay. That's a buried stone lying to team parent with the advantage. Definitely 3 points on the table here in the sixth end. It's going to take a real nice draw. Team Yamamoto. I bet Team Yamamoto felt pretty in control when they made that double peel call. Just hitting red stones, doing what they thought was best. But after that shot, it has been nothing but a nightmare for Team Yamamoto. Two made draws, perfectly made draws, have left them with not much to look at. As far as chasing those red stones, they were never going to get rid of all the guards. This is interesting. This is probably the most reliable shot. Follow Lisa down this same draw path if they can. Try to get a piece of the 4 foot. There is no run back available for team parents. So if Sae Yamamoto can get this rock to the tee line or deeper, I don't think there's going to be much of a shot for team parent. Sae Yamamoto to put the game away in the sixth end. Her last stone. This looks all over the guard, and it will be. Open draw for three. For Lisa Parent, they get their wish. The team from Calgary able to string together three shots in a row. That was finally the ticket. They hadn't put that many shots together yet. Now, all of a sudden, a big opportunity to get right back in this game. Sweeper's watching this one down. Does look heavy. Is it going to hang on? It does. Hangs on at the back of the 8 foot by a few inches. 3 points. Team parent able to put four shots in a row together for the first time this game. And what do you know? It scores them 3 points. We've got a game. 6-4, Yamamoto leads it with hammer, heading into the seventh end.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
Sometimes curling just isn't as fun as it can be on the Nintendo Switch. With up to 4 players per console, you can enjoy curling with your friends and family anywhere, anytime. Let's play curling. Available now only on Nintendo Switch.
Welcome back, 7th end. It's a huge score of 3 for Team Parent. Puts themselves back in the conversation. Still going to take a big effort here. They'd really like to force Team Yamamoto to single point in the 7th end. Try to go into the 8th with the same goal as the 6th. Score 3. That'll tie the game. Give them a shot in the extra end. Yeah, a hogged guard is not going to help. Open draw to the side of the rings for Team Yamamoto. No need for guards. Optimal here for Yamamoto is to blank the end. Keep hammer and a 2-point lead into the 8th. If they must, they will score a point. They don't want to give up a steal and make this game a 1-point game. A blank or a single are their best options. Of course, 2 or more points is going to be lovely, but the strategy here will be to go for a single point. If they're going really hard for a blank, you may have seen Team Yamamoto throw that one through the rings, but with a perfectly made draw to the side of the rings, it's going to give them a great opportunity to score one or more points here. Team Parent, understandably, will need to go all out here. As if this end is the final end of the game, will be the general strategy. Makes the first red go away. Bad adjustment. Makes about a 20-foot adjustment. Throws the next guard into the rings. That's going to really hurt Team Parent's chances. Although, Yamamoto fairly lackadaisical, you know, careless, whatever you want to say, about where that shooter ended up. That's not a good place for her to leave her yellow shot rock or her yellow shooter stone. That is going to give a sort of overlap center line guard opportunity to Team Parent. Working really hard just to get a rock in play at this point. Sweepers do get it there. Crosses the hog line and then some. Oh, maybe the commentator was being a little dramatic there. That's healthily in the free guard zone. So as you can see from this straight on view, you got a centerline guard high, a Yamamoto stone just in front of the rings low. That's going to be more than enough, mess down the center for Team Parent to manufacture a steal here. So even though the first rock hogged, second rock was in the rings, Team Parent is going to have some type of opportunity. Calling a tap back here, I can scarcely believe my eyes. Like, makes it fairly well, but just look at that scenario it's created. This is a disastrous playground for Yamamoto. I'm not sure why they would encourage more rocks in the control area. Enough 2 points with hammer. That's just going to give Team Parent more opportunity to make freezes and tap backs and try to manufacture something here. That's a pretty bad miss. You do not want to miss heavy. If anything, you want to leave that light, create more centerline guards and such. So, an open opportunity to peel this stone for Team Yamamoto. They've been pretty solid with their peels so far. Haven't stuck one yet or flashed one. This one's looking pretty good as well. Takes the top one. Leaves the center line mostly open. Might see Team Parent try to lay this guard a little closer to the existing Yamamoto stone. Might create a jam opportunity if Yamamoto was to ever try to take on a double peel. But if we see successful guard peel for the rest of the end, Team Parent will have an opportunity to lie two and force Yamamoto to one, which is a very acceptable result. The only thing better being a steal. But hey, making Yamamoto throw against two here in the seventh end, especially with the way things started, that's going to be a victory. Team Parent. A little bit of curl is going to make this rock perfect. Comes a touch deep, but that's just fine. Definitely has tempted Team Yamamoto into trying this peel on the outturn side, attempting to get a double. But what they should be aware of is if they get this thin and jam onto their own, they're going to leave a center guard. So don't want to do that. Looks pretty close. Oh, sorry, folks. A bit of a camera snap back there. That's how it deals with the lag, is snaps back to real time. So it looks like they did make contact with that red stone on the side of the house. Pushed it over to the edge of the 12 foot. That's a huge shot. That went from Team Parent lying one after trading peels and guards to Team Yamamoto lying two now after trading peels and guards. Nothing really obvious to freeze to for Team Parent. That's going to be a huge, huge swing making that double. Yeah. looking for a center guard. He's going to slip into the rings. Not a huge deal. Team Yamamoto was going to target this rock anyways. Doesn't make a massive difference if it's in the rings or not. You'd really just be hoping for a pure miss anyways. Not sure what the discussion is here. Gotta rip that thing out of the house. No matter what turn you take. You would think you'd take the turn that wouldn't jam into your other two stones, but seemed to be a bit of a point of discussion there. Not really throwing peel weight at this, are they? Trying to get it across the face now. Very interesting. They're going to leave it right on the center line. Definitely not where you want to leave that. That's going to make a freeze opportunity more available for a team parent. It means that you only have one crack at, like, let's say team parent freezes to the back yellow. Now you only have one direction to hit it on. So if team parent leaves a bias on the one side, it's sticking right there. So some questionable tactical decisions kind of throughout the game from Team Yamamoto. But the principle of leaving rocks in the kind of action zone, they definitely have not been respecting that idea. The Team Yamamoto has been leaving their stones in positions that I would consider favorable for team parent. Full sweep, gets that stone, full 12 foot. Good enough for third shot, it looks like. Very promotable. It's in a fairly good spot. Yeah, it's going to force Team Yamamoto to either hit that one, which doesn't look very attractive. There's definitely a way to jam that. Even if they make it, they'll leave their rock kind of in a controlling spot. Definitely not an optimal look for Team Yamamoto having to draw around a pile to the 4 foot, leaving a tap back opportunity for team parent that's going to pretty effectively create a force scenario or maybe even a steal scenario. Have to question the tolerance that Team Yamamoto has had for keeping parents' rocks in play, considering just an end before they were peeling everything in sight even when there was no opportunity to clear all the guards. So weird changing of gears here, tactically. Team Yamamoto does not seem to like the look of this there. Standing with their kind of hands on their hips, not really loving what they're about to throw. at this point, I don't really see what else you do besides hit the top red. Full sweep on this one, end to end. Really trying to drag everything they can out of it. And they do. Great sweep. Gonna put them on the side of the button. Really well managed sweep. Nice shot, Sae Yamamoto. However, even though it's very nicely made, this outturn tap back is super available. Lisa doesn't even need to get shot rock here. If she puts this anywhere in the top four, it's going to create a really difficult shot for Yamamoto to remove it. Just leave it. Last shot, Lisa Parent, seventh end, trying to keep this comeback story alive. Looks pretty good. Tap is made. Raise successful. Beautiful shot. Called and made. Lisa Parent leaves her rock in that outturn path. Of course, there is a straight run back here. Did just get a little bit on the high side of the yellow rock, but tough to be picky at that point. Tough one here, but it is for the game if she makes it. I suppose there is a way to only count one here, but you think if that rock goes flying out of the rings, it will be game over. Sue Yamamoto. Rock is definitely curling on them. And they will not remove the red stone. It will be a steal of one, and this comeback story continues. Team Parent picks up a huge point in the seventh. We'll try to do the same in the eighth when we come back.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
Welcome back. Quite a comeback story we have brewing here. Lisa Parent down 6-1 after four ends. 6-1 after five ends, sorry. Even more impressive. Got a big three in the sixth end. There's no other way to say it. Really just strange tactical decision-making, Team Yamamoto in the seventh end. Had them on the ropes. There was no center guards. There was no danger down the middle. Team Yamamoto leaving their rocks around down the center line gives Team Parent the sort of situation they needed to try and get a freeze tap or get a shot rock in there, make a really difficult shot for Yamamoto's last. Yamamoto does miss. It is a steal. And now, just like that, from 6-1, 6-5, score three, steal a one. Team Parent will try to do the same thing. They do make their center guard. It's been a struggle at lead tonight. But they do get a good center guard on their first one. Now they'll try and get that potentially game-winning shot into the forefoot on their second stone here. It is important that this rock ends up in the forefoot. In theory, Team Parent may spend the rest of the end guarding this thing. So this one's got to either be shot rock or frozen right on top. This looks pretty good. Sweepers get it there. Best two shots of the night from lead Megan Johnson. Great time to throw two beauties like that as you're trying to make a big comeback. And all of a sudden, we got a game. Hey, never say never. You will recall me back in the fifth end. I said it does happen. I watched it happen 3 or 4 weeks ago with Jacques Gauthier. He did win that game in an extra end. However, after giving up a five-point lead. And Brendan Botcher in the Briar 2018, down 5 points. Came back and won in the eighth end. Didn't even need an extra end. Team Parent looking to join the likes of Jacques Gauthier and Brendan Botcher with a comeback victory here in Leduc. Hardline Curling Stadium, Alberta Curling Series. They will get a miss. That Yamamoto shot does come deep. So now an opportunity to tap their stone up. Maybe there's enough room to get shot rock here. If Team Parent can ever get shot stone with some backing behind it, they will be in a favorable position to tie this game with a series of guards. But they do need something from their front end here to make it happen. This is really wide, this stone. Does not have a shot at tapping anything. That's going to go down as a missed opportunity for sure. They got the miss they needed while the free guard zone was still in play. But they fail to either make the tap back or leave their rock in a good position. So this will be peel number one. Team Parent, not dead yet. There is still a good opportunity to make a tap back or kind of run back. Leave two rocks in the top four. And force Yamamoto to make a good shot on her last. Of course, there's always the opportunity for a stuck peel or a flashed peel. And that'll be a team meeting. Team Yamamoto have already used their timeout. Definitely worth a discussion here. Now that they've gotten a missed guard, will they address this 4 foot stone right now? Will they attempt to lose their own, or will they try to pick it straight out? I think optimal here is to lose both stones in the 4 foot, including their own. Don't want to give team parent anything to freeze to or anything that might make your last shot some type of a difficult draw to the button. You'll want to leave the 4 foot wide open for yourself. So a hit on this red stone is definitely what's in order. It's just what you want to do with the shooter and what you want to do with the back one is the decision to be made. Very soft weight here. Not sure why they're playing that so soft, but that might just be the hit weight they're comfortable with. Either way, gets the red out of the way. Does spill their yellow to a less than favorable position. That's going to be very freezable. That's what Team Parent will try to do right now. Try to shake off that missed guard and just do what they can do. It's better to miss light there than heavy, for sure. So, I mean, that is significantly light. You're looking at about 12 feet light there with sweeping. So, peeling that center guard. It'll be hit, hit, hit for the rest of the end here for Yamamoto. Still leaves that that rock in the side of the forefoot, so it looks like Lisa's going to attempt to... attempt to throw some more center guards, knowing on her last one that she will have that freeze opportunity. So center guard number two coming down the ice. Sweepers like it, keeping it clean. Ooh, really push that peel outside. Oh, but it's going to work out just fine. End goes pretty quick when the call is so obvious like that. Might be one more center guard before Lisa is forced to freeze on that yellow stone on the side of the forefoot. This one is curling. Perhaps they did call the freeze on this shot. Looks like they did. To hold that line just a little heavy, but that's going to be fine. The freeze is made. Even if Yamamoto is able to blast this one out of here, there will be another freeze opportunity available on the back one. It won't be for as much of the 4 foot, but there is still a chance to make an unremovable stone. Win is anything but guaranteed here at this point. Lots of stones to use for Team Parent. He's put together a pretty good end here besides that missed guard. This has been a fairly well-played end. Team Parent really getting their stuff together in the second half of this game, as the scoreboard would indicate. Team Yamamoto not necessarily missing that much, but definitely letting their opponent back in certain regards. This will be some big weight from Yamamoto. We have not seen much big weight from this Japanese team. This is a screamer. Sweeping to keep it straight. We'll get the one rock. Bounces out into the 12 foot. That's a great shot. Well made rip. Although, I'm not sure why they were sweeping it so hard. I feel like they would have wanted to get rid of their yellow rock in the side of the 4 foot. It's going to leave the exact same freeze shot available for Lisa Parent. She just threw this. Doesn't have to change too much about it. They're taking a little bit more ice, as the sweepers last time had to sweep for line a little bit, even though it was a touch heavy. So this will make it so the sweepers can wait on it a little while longer. What a story this game. If you would have told me after the sixth end, or the fifth end, sorry, that Lisa Parent would be throwing her last rock in the eighth end, I would have, I would have not believed you, but I would have thought that extremely unlikely. But here we are, a freeze to try and force an extra end. The opportunity is definitely there. Sweepers waiting on this one. They want to wait for some curl. Waiting to the end if they can. Looks pretty good. Beautifully swept rock. Excellent shot made. Team Parent doing everything they can with Lisa's shots. That's two nearly perfectly made freezes in a row. That's an impressive showing from Lisa Parent. Well, they've done what they can do. It's in Sae Yamamoto's hands now. Pretty much the same shot as her previous one. Looking to blast this redstone out of the 4 foot. They were defending a 6-1 lead at one point. Now they're defending a 1 point lead. They've had hammer for three straight ends in a row. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah, two straight ends in a row, but sweepers are waiting on this one. They need a bit of curl. They will collide into their own on the top eight. It will be another steal for Lisa Parent and her team. This game's going to extra ends. And the Cinderella, the comeback story, continues. 6-6 tie after eight ends. We will have the extra end for you. Yamamoto will have hammer once again when we come back.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.
Welcome back, Extra Ends. What a comeback. I'm going to move this camera up a little bit so you can see that scoreboard. It's been a doozy. Team Parent totally against the ropes, facing game over scenarios over and over again. Lisa able to pull her team out of the fire every now and then. Scores 3 points in the sixth end, a steal in seven and a steal in eight. Both basically manufactured by Skip Lisa Parent. And now we have a tie game. Extra ends. Yamamoto with hammer. Two really good shots made by the lead for Team Parent earlier on. Let's see if she can make two more. Not exactly sure what the placement was for those rocks, but it's two center guards. That's what's important. Tick shot attempt here. This seems entirely too heavy. Gonna whack that nose, that rock pretty firmly on the nose, and yeah, that'll sail right through. So rocks will be reset. Really good opportunity here for Team Parent. I mean, two missed shots off the bat for the lead. Those stones are going to be far more grouped than ideal, but three guards down the middle. I've seen extra ends start off much worse. Yeah. It is peeling time, though. Five rocks have come down the ice. It is time to bang. Jeez. Lining up the most difficult of these doubles is Skip Sae Yamamoto. I'm going to have to get this one pretty thin. It looks like a natural jam to me. Might be going for perfection here at a time where it's going to do the trick to just make the easy one. This is going to be really inside. And they're going to make the simpler double. Perhaps something along the lines of what they really should have been calling in the first place. They got two rocks going. They did leave their shooter up front, but that's going to be pretty easy to double peel. Get your shooter in a better position. But hey, team parent going to take this all day. More or less overlap center guards. It's going to be a good opportunity to get their steel stone right where they want it, side of the button. And ideally, they spend the rest of the end guarding that. Force Sae Yamamoto to a draw to the button is the objective here. Big shot here. If they can get this one to the side of the button, it's going to look really good for a steal. Sweepers like it. They're waiting for it. They're going to have to crush it at the end for some line. We'll go to the overhead. That is exactly where Lisa Parent put her broom out. Well, I spoke a little too soon, didn't I? Foot higher, but guess what? That's going to be more than good enough. You're going to happily guard that stone all end, force Yamamoto to a draw to the button. When was the last time Sae Yamamoto threw a draw? I think it was in the first half of the game, over an hour and 15 minutes ago. So got to take that. Looking to make this double peel. Apologies, folks. The camera snapped ahead like 7 or 8 seconds there. So it looks like it's tough to say. They either took the red one off or... Yeah, I think they just took the red one off. Or they stuffed a yellow. I don't know. It's tough to say. Really good opportunity. That's a center guard in place right now for Team Parent. I don't think they need to put another one in the 4 foot. I think another guard's going to do the trick just fine. It's going to force Yamamoto to make some type of run back or double peel and wait for a miss. The advantage right now is in Team Parent's hands. They fought for 8 ends to get to this moment. Just an incredible comeback and just a snapback for sure. Like some ends with like really, really badly missed shots, like 20 feet of weight difference or maybe 2 feet of ice difference, like some really bad misses. But geez, and at the end of the sixth end, it all turned around. It all turned around when Sophie Brissett made a draw to the 4 foot, a perfect draw to the 4 foot. And I remember saying out loud, man, that must feel good to finally make a team shot like that. And they have been rolling ever since. Yamamoto playing pure defense. I'm not exactly positive they know exactly what that type of tactic is. Oh, juicy double run back coming here. 1, 2. Oh, they just missed the stone in the forefoot. This game has become wildly entertaining, folks. I am at the edge of my seat. Jeez, Team Yamamoto almost making it all better with a run back triple. They just blow it by. They do leave a center guard still available. Team Parent survived that one by just the skin of their, you know, whatever. Pick your metaphor. They're going to try to replace that rock, about half buried. touching the center line, but also behind the corresponding center guard. Make that double run back a little more difficult. They don't want to line it up exactly as well as they did last time. Sales pretty deep. That's going to be a no-no. They may have set up some type of double. Oh, looks like the ice maker has called a timeout. He's got to drag that scraper. It's been a 2-hour and 40-minute game. So that's all that needs to be said. Ice maker's got to do his work. Oh, you're kidding me. He's going to take the scraper across the hog line, the field of play? I can't say I've ever seen that before. This game's just getting wild and wacky, folks. There's no other way to put it.
Thank you.
Not sure how long I was on mute there. Folks, apologize. Using their second timeout here. I did not know there was two timeouts, but here we are. Looks like I've been on for over 4 or 5 minutes. I apologize, everybody. I just don't want to hear you. I don't want you to hear me drinking my water. So I forgot to turn it back on. But looks like we missed the call on that massive double takeout by third rock thrower Momoka Iwasi. I've got some updated lineups here. So throwing third rocks for Team Yamamoto. Momoka Iwasi. She gets around the center guard. She throws back the two parent stones in the top of the 8 foot and on the side of the button. And she really turns this end around here. We did see an attempt at making a come around by Lisa. Skip Lisa Parent. She was significantly heavy. That was a rock sort of outside the established path. We thought we might see something like that, where it was a little quick. So after a coach's called timeout, it looked like Sae Yamamoto was going to come around that outturn side, try to plant a rock in the top of the 4 foot before Lisa Parent could. I thought that was a fine call, but coach waved his hands at the glass, called a timeout while Sae was in the hack, which is what happened last time out as well. Coaches are allowed to do that. They are allowed to signal for a timeout. Coaches cannot make any type of suggestive motion, nod their head yes or no or anything like that. The only signal they can make to the ice is a timeout symbol. So looks like their coach used that power again, kind of called off the shot just before it was too late. The peel call is in my opinion, just as logical. You're getting that guard out of the way. So now when Lisa puts something in the forefoot, you'll have either a pick type shot or a short run back. It's a way of guaranteeing yourself some type of shot. If you go for an outturn draw and you come heavy, Lisa comes and freezes, you have no shot. If you go for an outturn draw and you miss outside or something, Lisa has that same draw. So it is definitely a risk management type of call. But it does leave the 4 foot open for Lisa Parent. Oh, bit of a camera skip there. Lisa Parent to try and complete this comeback. They need to lie one in order to make Sae Yamamoto throw her last rock. They'd love to catch a piece of the button and make Sae Yamamoto throw a difficult shot. Looking for some late curl here. Sweepers are right off. This rock will cruise to the back of the 8 foot, mostly open. Not what Team Parent was looking for. Hey, it's going to make Sae throw her last rock. And back when this team was down 6-1, I think they'd be pretty proud of themselves for getting to a point in an extra end where they make Sae Yamamoto throw her last stone. Sae Yamamoto, last rock, extra end. Needs to make contact with this red rock to win the game. Looks pretty good. And the camera skipped ahead. Looks like she made it. What an incredible game. Really, what a fight by Team Parent. Kept their heads. It all started with that Sophie Brissett draw to the forefoot in the sixth end to set up a three-point end. And then Team Parent really found their groove. First draw can often be a pretty funky one. And 2 hours and 50 minutes into this first draw. We have a 9-end final. 7-6 for Team Yamamoto. Find a way to figure it out. Hey, I'm looking at the chat right now. I'm saying I'm hearing good game. What a wild game. Nice game. Very fun game. Hey, I couldn't agree more. What a way to finish this first draw. I hope you'll join us again for draw two coming up. And I think it was scheduled for right now. I think we'll have to give the ice about 20 minutes to reset. But, hey, we'll be with you all weekend. Thanks so much for joining in. And, hey, congratulations for picking the right game. You got a wild one. Thank you very much. My name is Rory McCusker. I'll see you again this weekend. Have a great night, everyone, and have fun watching curling.
Imagine being able to stream every curling game from every sheet from any event, be it your Wednesday league game, Bonspiel, or corporate event. Curling Stadium offers an all-inclusive streaming solution featuring high-quality cameras, ease of use, great reliability, and minimal installation. Offering your sponsors customizable ad space on your streamed curling games and being able to sell video packages to your corporate events for increased revenue. With Curling Stadium, you can stream to any device, be it your mobile phone, tablet, or computer. Push the feed to your desired platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, or any other social media. Curling Stadium is simply the way forward. Where it's commonplace in other sports to televise every game, we want to do the same. Curling is a global sport, and it's time it gets the coverage it needs. Make your curling club the next Curling Stadium.
Looking to improve your game? Look no further than Hardline. We have all the curling equipment to help you make more shots and have more fun. It all starts with our flagship product, the Ice Pad Curling Brush, played with by 80% of the top men's and women's pro teams. We also carry a great line of shoes, pants, and curling accessories to help you play your best. Visit our website at hardlinecurling.com or one of our fine retailers around the world. Join the revolution and join Hardline Nation today.